Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video also we'll talk more about callback, some basic conditions of writing callback. So when we are passing, like add to argument, it has two arguments, a, b, and then callback, right? And how we are calling it, we are calling 2 and 5 and we are passing a function. So one basic thing we always need to do is the check that third argument which we are passing, that should be of type of callback, type of function, right? This is the main thing. And the important thing is, you might be thinking, okay, we are passing a function, why it's not getting executed? We are passing only the function name. The actual execution of function we are doing here, callback, we are, so passing a function doesn't make like we are executing it. We are executing it when you are putting these braces with a function name, then you are calling it, okay? So note that the callback function is not executed immediately. It is called back at some specified point inside the containing function body. Like you are executing here with some passing some value, right? So there are some best principles of implementing callback function. Used named or anonymous function as a callback. Here we can talk about some examples, okay? I'll try to put some example. So here we can replace it. I'm just using these examples so that we can save some time and can talk more. So here log stuff, right? This is the function we have, and in the user input, now we can actually call this get input method by passing some argument, and log stuff is a function we are calling. This is where we are passing the options and the function name, right? And callback options, right? So here log stuff is taking user data. These options we are taking, and we are just checking a type of string, type of object, and then we are doing some calculations and returning it, right? So the objective of this used anonymous function as a callback, and here is an example. In most of the cases, Node and Express ecosystem, we use anonymous function that were defined in the parameter or in containing a function. This is one of the common pattern. Like here we have a log stuff as a separate function, and here we are passing this, right? So another thing is, make sure callback is a function before executing it, so we can actually do a check. Here also we are actually doing a check that type of callback is of type function, then only return it. And there are many ways. And why we need a callback? So this is the example that here we are actually doing an asynchronous operation. Here load assets, okay? I'm calling this with these two options, blob and display image is a function, callback function. And I'm calling this display image. So load assets, callback is display image. And I'm calling it once I receive the data from the API. So hsr.onload, here you are actually initializing the hsr request, doing a send operations, and this will get executed once you receive the data. Here also you can check the XML HTTP hsr.onReadyState or hsr.status is 200, then only execute this. So we are going to wait till we get the response. And once response is received, we are doing hsr.response. And this callback will execute and we will get the data here. Okay, a simple example which is talking more about actual asynchronous operation using callbacks. Okay, thanks everyone. So in the next videos we are going to talk about prototypal inheritance, this keyword, and some tricky JavaScript problems.